Hey, welcome to the How to Master Persuasion module. And I'm really excited about this module because being able to persuade others to our point of view is one of the most powerful and effective skills that we can learn. And this module is going to be worth way more than the entire cost of this course. Because in it, I'm going to reveal to you one sentence that will dramatically change the way that you look at getting other people to do what you want them to do. Now, no doubt you've known people who are just masterful at persuading others, right? They get what they want. Perhaps they get free food when they go out, or they get other people to help them with their homework or help them move or whatever it is. And they do it almost effortlessly. Well, in this module, I'm going to teach you one strategy that you can use today that's going to help you, and it's going to really enable you to communicate with your ex in a way that is powerful and effective, a way that makes your ex feel like getting back together is their idea. So in this video, I'm going to tell you what this one sentence is. And then in the next few videos, I'm going to explain each part of this sentence one by one. There's five parts to it, and every part has its own nuance and its own potent power. Now, the sentence is this. This sentence is really the culmination of all sorts of different persuasion disciplines, whether it be NLP, whether it be any kind of other neuro-linguistic programming. They're all kind of combined and coalesced into this one sentence. And I can't take credit for this sentence. I actually learned it from a guy named Blair Warren, who coined the sentence and then explained it to me. And I think you're going to find it just as powerful. The sentence is this: people will do anything for those who encourage their dreams, justify their failures, allay their fears, confirm their suspicions, and help them throw rocks at their enemies. So there's five parts. People will do anything for those who encourage their dreams, justify their failures, allay their fears, confirm their suspicions, and help them throw rocks at their enemies. Now, just let that sentence kind of resonate with you. In the next few modules, there's five, I'm gonna go through each one: encouraging their dreams, justify their failures, allay their fears, confirm their suspicions, and help them throw rocks at their enemies. And I'm gonna do it in little bite-sized chunks so that you can take away each one and figure out which element is most applicable to you in your situation with your ex. Now, a thing to note here is that you're not going to use all of those motivations in your interaction with any one person. In other words, you're not going to encourage their dreams, justify their failures, allay their fears, confirm their suspicions, and help them throw rocks at their enemies all at once, because that would be very difficult to do. Instead, I'm going to teach you how to determine which of those five is the strategy that you want to use at any particular time. And it changes, right? Obviously, when people are afraid, they want their fears to be allayed. They want to feel unafraid. When they are suspicious, they want those suspicions to be confirmed. And so we're going to go through and teach how to do this. This one module, if you get nothing else out of this whole module or out of this whole course, learn this. Because if you do, then every interaction you have from now on, you will be in control of. One more note. In order for this to work, in order for these persuasion techniques to be effective, there has to be a certain amount of respect. Here's what I mean. We'll talk about this more in depth in each of the next modules, but let's just take encourage their dreams. I want you to imagine that you're walking down the street and you're kind of down on your luck and you end up talking to some homeless guy. And you're kind of bummed out because you're not really as successful as you want to be or whatever. You can come up with your own idea. Now, if some homeless guy starts talking to you and says, "Hey, listen, you know what, man? You can do it. I believe in you." How much is that going to mean to you? Well, if you're like most people, it's not going to mean much because this guy's homeless. What does he know? Now, if Donald Trump, or insert your most favorite successful person here, if he were to talk to you, or if she were to talk to you, and say, "Hey, listen, I believe in you," now, that means something because they know what they're talking about. This is critical for you to get. Okay? In order for these techniques to be effective for you, you have to reframe your relationship with your ex. And that's what I teach you in other parts of the M3 system. using the no contact strategy is a big part of that. Not just because it allows them to miss you, but also because it backs up and presses the reset button. Because if you're like most people, after the breakup, you've kind of lowered your value. Maybe you've called incessantly, or you've begged them back, or made all of these promises. And all of those things only make you look less credible. The no contact strategy, which is very important, and the reset button that it allows you to press is what allows these persuasion techniques to be super powerful. In other words, if you get off the phone with your ex after just begging them or promising to change or doing anything that was not effective, and then call them up immediately afterwards and say, hey, let me encourage your dreams, well, they're just not going to believe you. So use the other parts of the M3 system to make this punctuate your communication. The other parts of the M3 system are made to prepare you for this, and they really work in harmony and in symphony. Okay, so that's the overview. The sentence is, people will do anything for those who encourage their dreams, justify their failures, allay their fears, confirm their suspicions, and help them throw rocks at their enemies. Let's take a look first at encouraging their dreams.